What I'm having currently is a premium beef rice box meal that I got from Taichi Bubble Tea. When my mom took me there. While picking me up from the Wegmans I work at to take me back to my dad's place. Though this Tai Chi bubble tea location we went to, and that we usually go to, is considerably out of the way compared to my dad's place. As the Taichi bubble tea location me and my mom usually go to is at the local mall of my mom's area. So I'm not really sure if me and my mom going to Taichi Bubble Tea counts as a stop on the way to my dad's place. But I enjoyed going there. And so did she. While at Taichi Bubble Tea, besides this, I also ordered a bowl of spicy tonsoku. Ramen. With pork. And for a beverage, I got a boba beverage. I opted for the chocolate smoothie variant. I saw advertised on a poster on the glass door of one of the entrances to the Taichi Bubble Tea location. And I also got a bag of shrimp chips. As usual, when I saw those were available for purchase on the wooden table that displays Japanese snacks. Available for sale. I had the ramen and the boba drink as soon as I got back to my dad's place, which was around 2:15 p.m. I worked at Wegmans today from 8 in the morning to 1:30 p.m. During which I most often restocked the banana section of the produce department and the hard item section of the produce department. Which is right in front of the banana section. And is where you'll find predominantly various potatoes and onions. Though there was a point in which I spent about half an hour to 45 minutes restocking the mushroom section, of the produce department, which is on the same side as the bulk wall. Of the produce department. And in terms of front to back, with the banana section and hard item section being at the back, pretty much. The mushroom section is in the middle, or at most slightly in front. There were points also in which I briefly restocked merchandise for the bulk and convenience walls. The bulk wall of the produce department is on the right side, while the convenience wall is on the left side. From the perspective of looking towards the front of the produce department, from the back of the produce department, in this case, having your back to the banana section, while being in front of it, essentially between the banana section and the hard item section. I took my first and only 15-minute break today, around 1 p.m., during which I walked to the cafe part of the supermarket and had part of a calzone. A female friend of my dad got from Salvatore's. I decided not to heat that calzone up in the break room microwave, and instead had that calzone cold to ensure that this 15-minute break wouldn't be more than 15 minutes. I recall the calzone had meat and cheese, but I don't know the specifics at this time. But it was an enjoyable calzone. I recall waking up to the 6 in the morning alarm I set on my laptop through a third-party website. And getting up within roughly 7 minutes or so. Around 6:15 in the morning, I had with my first cup of plain coffee today. Half of a specialty cronut my dad got from the Salty Bread Pizza Cafe the other day. I recall this variety essentially being blueberry cheesecake. Me and my dad left around 7 in the morning so my dad could drive me to the Wegmans I work at. I recall preparing 2 cups of plain coffee from 2 coffee pods while waiting for the start of my shift in the break room. I finished the first cup of plain coffee, then prepared the second one, and finished that cup within the first 45 minutes of my shift, and then sipped at cooler water from the break room over the next hour and a half or so. One glass, from what I recall. During my shift, there were a couple points in which I briefly restocked some pineapples for the tropical section of the produce department. I recall it was roughly 2 boxes each time. Making for a total of roughly 12 pineapples in total. I recall the second time it was 12 pineapples, and then the first time it was 10 pineapples because one of the boxes had just 2 pineapples out of a full box being 8 or so. I recall first sleeping today from 3:30 in the morning to 6 in the morning. Then I slept roughly from 3 p.m. to about 7 p.m. I recall briefly waking up to an alarm I set on my laptop, again using a third-party website, for 6 p.m., but I ended up falling back asleep after I turned that alarm off. Even though I set that alarm because I originally intended to, get up at 6 p.m., as I planned on attending a webinar from 7 to 8 p.m., though it ended up lasting until roughly 8:30 p.m., though I only stayed till about 8:20 p.m. or so. I recall waking up for the last time today, about a handful of minutes after 7 p.m., and I only ended up being about 7 minutes late to the webinar. And thankfully, I didn't really miss anything. Probably just some introductionary stuff. Nothing really significant. I recall having the 1 cup of coffee I had at my dad's place from 6:15 in the morning to 6:45 in the morning. I recall around 7 in the morning, around the time my dad drove me to the Wegmans I work at. It was a cool summer morning, but by the time I was back at my dad's place after my mom picked me up from the Wegmans I work at. And we got back from Taichi Bubble Tea, which prepares orders pretty quickly, historically, and today was no different. By the time I got back at my dad's place, it had warmed up considerably to a pretty hot summer day. The kind of temperature you would expect for a summer day. As of now, I haven't had any of the bag of shrimp chips, which is currently at my dad's place. My mom also gave me a 3-pack of black ink gel pens she got for me the other day, giving me the 3-pack of pens as soon as we were back at my dad's place. My mom also gave me a Poland Springs branded plastic bottle of water. Though, as of now, I've only had one sip out of that bottle of water. Throughout my shift at Wegmans, I occasionally offered assistance to passing customers, though in those cases, they declined. Whenever a passing customer needed assistance with something, usually to look for a specific product within the produce department, they got my attention, not the other way around. And in those cases, I did my best to help them. First, by trying to look for that product on the floor of the produce department, and if I didn't find it there, I would look for it in the back or the part of the employees-only warehouse dedicated for the produce department, those who work there. All in all, I did my best to assist passing customers. And to just generally be friendly and helpful.